Hey y'all.
So all of my food is done. About to pour my good old butter sauce in a bowl. For y'all to see. Sit there right there. So here is my sauce. And I got my B-Love dry seasoning. This is my Old Bay and my Tony's. I had to break up my crab leg, my king crab, into three parts to get it into the pot. So this would have been my king crab right here. That would have been it. Is it the other way? Hell, I don't goddamn remember. Like this. And then the little tail piece. Or like that. I don't know. Anywho, we got the king crab. We got the snow crab leg. We got potatoes, corn, and an egg. I was gonna put some broccoli in there, but I didn't feel like all that. My crab leg, my snow crab starting to get cold. Okay, so this is gonna be the true test of this sauce, y'all. I want y'all to be able to see my sauce. I'm gonna put the sauce right here on my thing so y'all can see my sauce when I dip in it. Okay, right there. Smell good, bring it back, yeah. Okay, so here we go. God's great, God's good. Let's talk about food, about things, y'all. Faith, think about the brain. Amen. Amen, honey. Now let's see. Ooh, hot. Okay, it's sweet. It's still, that ain't the flavor that I'm used to. I'm from Florida, so we do garlic crabs, like straight garlic butter. So good. Tastes better than this, in my opinion. Ooh, this shit is real hot. But, and whatever. I wanna, well actually I'm gonna put it in this, dip it in that. Yo, I think without the Worcestershire, I'm gonna just sit my potato down. This, ooh, yeah, this right here, this shit bang. I'm about to just goddamn. I should've just put one corn on my thing. I'm about to goddamn sprinkle that bit on everything. I wanna save some so I can dip my stuff in. And I got me a Diet Coke. And I pulled up a pair of scissors. Let me try the kink. I want a shrimp. I want to get up in this butter, but it's so damn hot. Let me try onion. Ooh! Shit. Damn. This butter hot as hell. I'm been that scald my goddamn mouth. I like the sweetness that's in it, though. I can fuck with this butter. Next time I make, I'm not saving this butter right here. I should not put that damn Worcestershire sauce in there. But with the butter by itself, with just that dry seasoning mix, that shit is hitting. You hear me? Hot. Yeah. Without that, what you call it? Without that, I ain't got no nails, y'all. So if y'all don't know, I'm a nurse. And like for the longest, I've been wearing nails still at work, but now I'm in the OR and they trip about it. So I had to take my nails off and they so soft and sore. And what you call it? It's hard for me to peel stuff because I ain't got no damn nails. So y'all, I'm peeling off this back thing. And then this boo-boo right here, y'all be eating that boo-boo. I ain't eating no shrimp boo-boo. Take that out. I eat the meat off the top of the boo-boo. But the boo-boo, uh-uh. I'm peeling all that. That's meat. Boo-boo right here. Y'all see that? Damn. Oh, shit, a boo-day. This piece won't come out. God damn it. Cut the bitch out with the knife. I ain't got time for you goddamn. Y'all see that? Okay. And honestly, I feel like the Worcestershire kind of got stuck into the actual butter itself and not really the seasoning part. Because I would just dip my stuff straight at the top, but that seemed like where most of the damn vinegary tasted. So, whatever. Got me a boiled bird leg. Sit that in there. Who this butter hot? Shit. I want to get my potato out of there. I should have got me a fork. Oh, shit. Ooh, it burned my hands. God damn it. Ooh. Where my corn at? I'm going to just eat the corn. Fuck it. It's sweet. There's some white corn. First ripe corn from the farmer's market. I don't know why. It seemed like when I get fresh corn, that the kernels be smaller. I'm finna use my damn knife to dig my potato up out of here. Oh, shit, making a goddamn mess. It's all on the table. Ooh, it's like it'll cook my damn potato all over. This bitch is hot as hell. That's good though. Okay, let's try. First time in history, I'm trying king crab. Oh shit. This pan ain't big enough.
Okay,
so ooh-wee. Look at that. I'm trying to get it on that seasoning. You know what? I'm gonna just goddamn dump that big off enough. Okay. The meat tastes good. I really wish I would've just did my garlic butter. My Cajun garlic butter. I think I would be enjoying this more. It ain't bad. Let me not say that it ain't bad, but when I have crabs, it's a taste. That's the taste I'd be imagining. And I ain't getting that taste right now. I feel like even, like I said, if I would have not put that Worcestershire, it would have been tasting way better. It's spicy. It's a good spice though. It's not too hot. I want to taste better. Yeah. Ooh. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm done all the way in the bottle. Tastes real good. I think because this corn is so sweet. Dang, I'm on the, get some more on that. Yeah, this sauce, it's growing on me. Yeah, I should be the headless mukbanger. Cause that's what the hell look like. The way y'all, you know what? I think I got a tripod somewhere. A little mini tripod. I don't know what the hell I did with it though. That little motherfucker hitting right there, boy. For real. Y'all give me a motherfucking thumbs up if you dance while you eat. Because nigga like me. Can I say nigga on here? I don't want to be in trouble with that. Ooh, look. That onion. That little motherfucker right there, him. Let me give me some more shrimp. People like that. Do y'all like when people be burping? If not, my bad. Not that I wasn't gonna not burp, but excuse me though. Bruh, okay. So that meat seasoned real good. If y'all be liking to watch these crab leg videos, I'm pretty sure y'all done seen light skin Keisha and Coca Bango. Her boyfriend. Do y'all watch them? And if you do, write in the comments and tell me. Bruh, it was one video I was just watching they had posted. Oh yeah, this butter way better now. I could dip all the way up in there. It ain't too hot. Once this sauce is simmering down, it tastes better. Ain't that bad. I still like my garlic butter better, but I could fuck with it though, because I was thinking that it was nasty. But they went to King Crab ATL. This boy playing with the damn crab legs. I'm like, oh, the meat that this boy leaving. I cooked them too long, them potatoes. All that damn meat that this boy leaving on these crab legs. Somebody crack these damn crab legs for this boy. Wasting all that meat. That's all I was thinking. Anyway, y'all, so I don't know if y'all been hearing or seeing stuff on social media or whatever about all this damn sex trafficking that's going on in Atlanta. Like, the shit is not new. It's been going on, but I guess it's getting worse. I have read something about, what you call it, about, somebody got busted, and it was a whole bunch of girls. I don't want to lie. I think there might have been hundreds of them, though, that they found or rescued or whatever. So I don't know if they, like, trying to replace the girls that they missing, or not necessarily missing, the girls that's done been found, and now they don't have them to make money off of no more, so they trying to replace them with some new people or new women or whatever. So I don't know if that's what's going on or what. And the crazy part is, like, well, one of the girls that was found recently in Decatur, actually. So she went missing from Clark, Atlanta. They was thinking that she got abducted, like, was being sold for sex trafficking and all of that. And come to find out, her best friend boyfriend killed her, some shit like that. They found her not far from my mama house, actually. And hell, that's only like 15-20 minutes from me, and that shit is freaking crazy. A girl got abducted on Candler Road, that worked at that Red Lobster right there. My mama lived like 10 minutes from that. Her house is not that far, like, going towards, what's that? Is the oven? Oh, it's the oven on. How much the hell I keep hearing? Let me turn the oven off. Excuse me. But, yeah, some of these potatoes too soft. But, yeah, the girl was They took her from the bus stop in front of that by Red Lobster on Kendall Road, and she said she woke up in a hotel room. It was like four dudes beat and raped her, and then they started selling her, and it was a 15-year-old girl with her. And by the time they found them, not for that squirt. By the time they found them, the 15-year-old girl was in the closet dead. Ain't that some shit? Your goddamn daughter been missing all this time, and when they finally find her, she dead. Like, that's some scary shit. And, my mama always be telling me, like, stop going to the grocery store late. Going places, getting gas, and this and that. And I always just be like, I'm grown, like, whatever. Like, not even that, but just, like, I ain't feel like it was that deep. Like, I feel like I be aware of my surroundings. I park close to the entrance at the grocery store. So, I be feeling like I'm straight or whatever. Child, how about I seen something on, somebody posted something talking about them trying to take this girl, put a girl in a van at the Walmart on Panola Road, which is a Walmart that I go to sometimes. And I have been there late at night during a weekday. And what's crazy is, like, literally a few weeks ago, actually, I was at that Walmart one night. I had went there to get some coffee and to have for work the next day. And I don't know why, I felt somebody was following me or some shit. I felt like somebody was fucking following me. And I hurried up and rushed to my car. And it was a dude standing in at the truck right next to me. And it was like, he seemed like he was standing there like he was waiting for me to come to the car or some shit. Girl, I got in the damn car so fast. I had my taser with me too. And I put my taser out because I'm like, bitch, try me if you want to. I was screaming like a motherfucker out here. I eat a shell. I was screaming like a motherfucker out here. But shit, they don't care. Them folks will be waiting for you. Shoot your ass up with something. I seen something where they were saying that, like, you come to your car and there'll be a piece of paper on the windshield or something. They have medication inside that on the, like some kind of powder on that paper that when you touch it, it'll make you pass out. And that's how they're getting people. Like, child, you never know what the hell people would do. Like, there's some crazy ass motherfuckers out here, boy, for real. You gotta be careful. And not even just with the sex trafficking, just in general. Like, people trying to rob you or steal your damn car. You know, it's the holidays is coming up. People gonna be on 10 with that. Be safe, lock y'all doors, getting your cars broken into and shit like that. Getting your house robbed. Like, be safe. That's one thing I said, I need to get my license to carry because I have a gun, but I usually leave it at home. But now I'm about to start carrying that bitch with me. And I know I have to have it in my car, but I want to legally be able to keep it in my purse. You feel me? Yeah, I'm full. I ate two or three legs off of this. One and a half corn on the cob. Maybe one whole potato and an egg. Like, two shrimp. But I really want to try to get into this part. How do the knuckle meat taste? Let's see. Mm. tastes like, what is it? Can I say that tastes like? Crab meat, duh. I'm thinking about like lump crab meat. That'd be good, some crab cakes. That meat right there. It's real thick. It ain't as flaky as the one inside that knuckle. It's a lot thicker. Shit. Okay, I'm gonna taste this piece of meat. And then I'm gonna be done. But yeah. So, back. Oh shit, I cut my finger. Back to what I was saying just about the whole sex trafficking stuff. Like, even if you're not in Atlanta, I know the shit is going on other places too. It's just that it's, I think, a lot more probably going on here because of the airport and all of that stuff. Like, you know, it's an international airport or whatever. But y'all be safe out here. Watch y'all back. Y'all kids, young girls and young boys, they after them too. So y'all be safe. Be safe out here in these streets. Oh my God. Baby, this thing heavy. Look at that. My whole hand. Uh-oh, I'm dropping pieces. This will be so good with some garlic butter. Y'all know which one I'm gonna put it on. Okay. I'm so full. I wanna sprinkle it. Look at that. Oh my God. They're so good. I know I'm smacking so bad. I'm sorry. I hate people smack like that. But it just, my whole mouth was filled up with meat. Ooh, that sounds bad. Y'all know what I mean. Damn, fool. I don't know how this is gonna taste if I really warm back up. Let me just go ahead and eat it. So, the question of the day is, will I try Be Little Sauce again? I'm from Duval. I like all the crabs. But, I mean, it ain't, I might will try it again without the Worcestershire. But honestly, I think garlic butter for the win. Garlic butter for the win. I think this is an acquired taste. Definitely. Definitely. I don't see how the hell did they be eating this on top of squirting it with lemon juice. Look at that. All that meat in there. They were just throwing them knuckles in the trash. Y'all. So, it has been real. I can't eat not nay another piece. Because I am beyond full. It's been real. Sitting and eating, chatting with y'all. It's been real sitting and chatting with y'all and eating, trying king crab for the first time, trying to do a mukbang or whatever. Y'all write in the comments and let me know if y'all like these type of videos. I don't know if I'm gonna put it in one or two parts. Me cooking the sauce and then me actually eating. Maybe that's what I'll do. So, anywho, I'm about to clean this up. And whew, I gotta lay down because I made too much. I kind of feel sick. So, yeah. Anywho, I'll holla. Love y'all. Let me know if y'all want to see some more videos like this. I think I said that already. Yeah, I probably did. Anywho, love y'all. Toodles.